Get ready to match the stars. Foster Brooks, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Real People, Sarah Purcell, Scoey Mitchlll, and Fannie Flagg, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, friend, for joining us. Well, we've got the stars and we've got the money to give away, so let's see if we can put them all together and give some money away. Over here we have Edie Stewart. Come around down here, Edie, and talk to me. She's won the game, and she's going to have a go at the big money stand right there in a little blue dot, if you would, please. Would you refresh in our memories a little bit as to where you're from and all that?
I'm from Fullerton, and a grocery checker, and mother of two.
All right. Who's minding the store?
Their dad.
Their dad, okay. Here we go, Edie. We polled a studio audience not too long ago and said, write down your best answer to this. Hey, listen, this would be a first. They forgot to put the guy in the box.
Here he comes.
Get in that box. Come here. Laurie, get out here. Laurie. Get in there, Laurie. Listen, this is our seventh year. It's the first time that happened. That's it had to happen sometime.
You didn't notice that Jane at all.
Well, you didn't.
No.
All right. We polled a studio audience and write down your best answer to this blank balsam. Now, if you say the answer they wrote down most often, you get $500. For matching the second most popular answer, you get $250. And then if you match the third, you get $100. Now, you can solicit answers from three of the six stars.
Okay. Fanny.
Wonderful, brilliant actor, Mr. Martin Balsam.
Marty Balsam.
Okay. Scoey.
Okay. That's how I feel, Joey.
The only thing I could think of was Martin, but Cheerio Balsam.
What is Cheerio Balsam?
Cheerio Balsam.
You think another one. You think of another one.
Charles.
I got a good one.
Oh, wait a minute. She's called on Charles.
You have no choice.
Okay. A very popular
answer.
A solution if you're losing your hair. Oil of balsam.
Oil of balsam.
Oh, heaven.
Hold
help
on.
Heaven,
oh, now, heaven. Hold on just a second here.
That's good.
This, some smart aleck in the audience thinks he has a better answer than any of those. Just, oh, wait a second. Now, hold on. Cut. The guy in the back row there with the glasses, stand up, if you would, please,
yes,
sir.
Yes, not, no.
Now, what is your answer?
Well,
of course. I tell you, nothing. They get the stars get a little cranky if the audience is smarter than they are. You see. Okay.
Yeah, beat it, Mac.
I never heard of her. Who is she?
So you have oil of balsam.
Ask him what the base of that shampoo is. Oil of balsam.
Oil of balsam. Oil of balsam, Cheerio Balsam, and Marty Balsam are the three they've given you. And now you can choose one of those or one of your own.
I'll take Well of Balsam.
You want Well of Balsam? Boy, if you're wrong, you're gonna get it. Okay, let's go down there and look at the $100 response. Alberto Balsam.
Who in heaven's name is Alberto Balsam?
Alberto Balsam.
A dancer.
It's a cousin of Wella Balsam. It's a... Thank you, John. Let's see if we get Wella Balsam out of the $250 response. Marty Balsam, the
ain't
actor.
Good for you, ain't Marty.
I know a funny story about him.
Yeah. All right, here's the last chance for Willa Balsam. Let's go. You got it. Sit down there and don't argue with me. You all right?
Oh.
Well.
I still think Cheerio Balsam was a good answer.
I didn't
Wait,
see
here
it.
Here comes Mr. Pushy now.
Here's the guy. What's your name?
Barry Kent.
Where are you from, Barry?
Fayetteville, Tennessee.
From Fayetteville, Tennessee. Bill Kent. Listen, I think you better go back. They're getting a little ugly. Fayetteville, Tennessee.
Oh,
Los Angeles is really a more hospitable town than you might get the impression it is.
Great.
Okay, now, Edie, you got $500, means the least you'll play for is 10 times that amount, or $5,000. However, we want you to spin the star wheel and see if you can double the money and play for $10,000.
Well, nobody up here is going to answer.
Yes, sir. Give it a go. Here we go. We're all rooting for a double.
Put his name up there.
Dave Wood, please. You are now playing for $10,000. Good luck to you, and this is it. Blank blind. B-L-I-N-D. Blank blind. Okay, now she's finished. If you give us the answer that she has on that card, you get $10,000. What do you say to that?
Sun blind.
Yes.
Oh, baby.
She kind of drew a blank on that, I'm sorry to say. She couldn't think of anything.
I am, too.
Other than
I thought
sun
we
blind.
Had a What'd winner. Venetian.
Venetian blind. Yeah. Very good answer, Brett. Well, Edie Stewart, you got $500 and 400 friends out there who helped you get the 500, and we thank you, and she thanks you. Now we got a little message for America. Here we go. We welcome back Jerry DeLu here. Remember her from yesterday's appearance? Want to refresh our memories about you, my dear? She's got a wonderful suntan, but she just came back from Hawaii, right?
Yes.
And
I live in Carlsbad, down by San Diego, and I'm in real estate.
All right. Here we go with game number two. This is the final game for you two ladies. Jerry, you may have A or B.
B, please.
All right. B says, the Hollywood producer said, there's something wrong with the casting in this movie. It's the life story of Orson Welles, and in the starring role, they've got blank.
I got it.
Everybody's ready. Jerry? Hollywood producer said there's something wrong with the casting in this movie. It's the life story of Orson Welles, and you know who he is. Mm-hmm. And in the starring role, they've got
Red Skelton. That's the only skinny person I can think of.
Red Skelton is the skinniest person you can think of.
I don't know.
All right.
Well, she was the same size.
She was on the right track. She was trying to name someone skinny, and she said Red Skelton, who is really not that skinny, is he?
Not anymore.
What do you say?
Well, no, I'm the only one in this room old enough to remember this fella.
Who's that?
Skinny Ennis.
Skinny Ennis.
You remember him?
Yeah. I've got a date with an angel.
Do you remember him?
Yeah. Yeah, he was with Hal Kemp's orchestra.
No, I was just saying, you're right, you're the only one old enough to.
Oh, I see.
What do you say to that?
I believe that for the first time this week, I do have the definitive answer.
Uh-oh.
Well, do you have the right
answer? Don Knotts.
Don Knotts is the definitive answer, that's right. Show us yours, sir.
Don Knotts.
Yes, sir.
Show it.
John, he's not only shorter than Orson Welles, he is skinnier than Orson Welles by a long shot. And you, madam?
Well, I was thinking of like a pint-sized Orson Welles, a smaller version, Mickey Rooney.
Mickey Rooney is all right. What have you got there for us, Scoey?
Well, I think that this would really give one cause to wonder about the casting. I said Sidney Poitier.
That's good.
Thank you.
Like that. What'd you put down in that card?
Kate Jackson.
Kate Jackson. Oh. Okay.
Oh, God.
Ready, Edie?
Yes.
This is yours. Nick said.
Yeah.
The
Arabs are investing in lots of insurance companies. Just think, now you'll be able to say, I've got a piece of the blank. For gifted game players.
Gifted game players.
Exactly. Nick said the Arabs are investing in lots of insurance companies. Just think, now you'll be able to say, I've got a piece of the blank.
Oil well.
Oh, you missed it too. I'm sorry. Are you familiar with the regular phrase, I've got a piece of the rock? You know, that's a slogan of a very well-known insurance company in America.
Yeah.
Well, in... what are you? Did you get it?
No.
You didn't get it either?
No, what have you got? I said desert.
He didn't get it either. Two terrific answers here. Say one of them.
I'll say Sphinx.
I got a piece of the Sphinx. All
right. That's one of the terrific. It's made of rock.
That's right.
It's made of rock, you idiots.
That's Egypt. Sphinx is one of the two terrific answers.
That's Egypt. Sphinx.
You mind your own business, Blondie.
Arabs. Egyptians are Arabs.
No, they're not. Egyptians are Egyptians, and Arabs are Arabs. I don't know.
Fannie, Saudi Arabia.
Study up on
they're all Arabs. They're all Arabs. What do you think they're all fighting about over there?
I'm sorry. I'm very confused.
About what?
I said oil well. I don't know.
I hate it so when a rotten answer wins.
Doesn't that tell you something?
Yes. Sarah? Just think, now you'll be able to say I've got a piece of the...
Only thing I could think of.
OPEC.
Now, I know what the word is. I've got a piece of the block.
Rock.
Block.
All right.
B-L-O-C. Block. Over in there.
Oh.
I've got a piece of the block.
You can say that if you want.
But did you?
Oh, it's a better answer than that, folks. I said pyramid.
There's the answer. That's the answer. That would be the
definitive.
Sphinx and pyramid were the two definitive answers. What do you got there, Fan?
Thank you.
Well, if Egypt is Egypt and Arabia is Arabia, I don't get it.
You flunked geography in addition
to
spelling.
Yeah. I said you have a piece of the sheik.
Oh, here we go. All right, let's go to round two. Edie, your head will ask you to go first.
B.
B it is.
Too smart.
When the archaeologists unwrapped King Tut's mummy, they were shocked. Inside King Tut's mummy was King Tut's blank. When the archaeologists unwrapped King Tut's mummy, they were shocked. Inside King Tut's mummy was King Tut's blank.
Body.
Is that the only thing you could think of?
No, I could think of something else.
What else did you think of, Edie? What?
No.
All right.
I'll pass.
You, sir, what do you say?
Timex.
Non sequiturs.
Still ticking,
right.
I might say.
Naturally.
Very good.
Now that's funny.
Yes, it is.
But the trick of this show is not to be so mirth provoking as it is not to be accurate, but to try and make sense out of this.
I wouldn't show that if I were you.
That is.
Okay.
mommy.
Sarah Purcell.
Well, it made sense to me to put instead of King inside of King Tut's mummy was King Tut's mommy.
Mommy.
Terrible, Sarah.
They get hostile, don't they?
Yes, they do. They don't like
it. I match sometimes.
What did you put, Scoey?
I said daddy.
There you go. Mommy.
I said it because I knew that was the right. That's the only reason I said it. I knew it was correct.
Correct. Yeah. Right. But you didn't
match.
What
did she say?
Body.
Yeah.
What do you say,
it
my
wasn't
dear?
Correct. No, it wasn't.
The archaeologists unwrapped King Tut's mummy, and they were shocked because inside King Tut's mummy was King Tut's...
Tummy.
King Tut's tummy and King Tut's
that
mummy.
Part of his body.
Now, you want to do a commercial now? All right, we'll do a commercial now. Don't go away because we've got business with you. Watch this if you please.
If you'd like to come to the studio out here in Hollywood and see Match Game in person, write to us. Enclose a self-addressed stamped envelope and mail your tickets. Match Game, CBS Television City, 7800 Beverly Boulevard, Los Angeles, California, 90036.
Here we go. This is the second question in the second round. Now, Jerry, you need one to tie, two to win. Ready? At the nudist colony. Okay, that's it. Make up your own question. At the nudist colony formal ball, Fred wore a three-piece outfit. It consisted of two black socks and a blank. Nudist colony formal ball.
I'm finished, Tom.
A three-piece outfit. It consisted of two black socks and a blank.
That's right.
Three-piece
outfit.
Now, Jerry, at the nudist colony formal ball, Fred wore a three-piece outfit. It consisted of two black socks and a...
hat.
And a hat. All right. Not too thrilled with that.
Look at you, the blonde.
You think that's a good answer?
Edie applauded it. Great.
What'd you say, Foster?
I beg your pardon?
She said hat.
We're very friendly.
She's hat.
Hat.
I said a pasty.
A pasty.
No, I said a tie.
What'd you say, Charles?
What'd you say, hon?
Come on, hon.
We're all anxious to hear
Come
what
on,
you
hon.
Said.
What'd you say, hon?
A garter belt.
Garter belt! Oh, I tell
That's
you.
Cute.
It's really wild up here today.
Gotta hold
Sarah
the socks up, you know.
Purcell. The English composer pronounced his name Purcell,
That's
not
right.
Purcell.
That's right.
What do you say?
Oh, who cares? Let's get on with the scoring.
I'm trying to.
What was Purcell's first name?
Why, Mr. Irving. Rayburn.
Yes.
Well, I thought that he should wear a top hat with his black
a
socks.
A top hat. Don't tie. Okay.
I thought it was a little less formal. I said a derby.
A derby. That wins the game for Jerry. What's that, Sandy? Amen. If you would, please. We're going to say goodbye to Edie Stewart, who leaves with $500 and our best wishes. Goodbye, Edie. Here we go. Yes. You're on the first team here. Jerry, we polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said to them, write down your best answer to this. Blank image, $500 for matching the most popular, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third. Three of the six will help.
Fannie?
I'm with you, hon.
Well, no, I have about seven or eight. Let me just sort it out. If somebody will write it down, I'll just sort it out. Okay. I think there are twins called mirror image twins.
Mirror image. Okay, there's one.
Brett? What I've always tried to maintain through my life, a good image.
Good image?
Scoey?
Watch it.
Beg your pardon?
She called on you.
Good image.
Oh, that's good. Wait a minute. Something may be coming to
We're
you.
We're missing one.
A bad image.
No,
so we have
wait,
a good image, a bad image, and a mirror image. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own. What would you like to do?
That's
on a TV
set. Mirror.
You want to say mirror image? Let's find out if it's up there. May we see the $100 response? Self-image is one. Let's go up the ladder and look at the next one, please. Mirror image, you've got it. What do you think's up on top there?
Bad.
Bad image. Slide the big one. Spitting image. Yeah. And you got $250, means at least you'll play for is $2,500. If you get a lucky spin of the star wheel, you double it and play for $5,000. Good luck to you. Here we go. You're playing for $2,500 with Sarah Purcell, and here we go.
Sarah.
Good luck. It says, hooked blank. That's H-O-O-K-E-D blank. Hooked blank. Got one? Don't say it yet. I'll call on you in a moment. Okay. If you give us the answer that she has on the card, you get the $2,500. What do you say to that?
Rug.
Hooked
rug.
Hooked rug.
Yay. Mm-hmm.
Hooked rug. She says we'll match it for the $2,500. What do you say to that, Sarah?
Hooked fish.
Hooked fish, you said.
Sorry.
Jerry, you have a total of $250 and our best wishes. Many thanks for being here on Match Game, and now we've got this message for you. Thank you, stars. You were wonderful. Join us next time for Match Game. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
Today's consolation prizes are Bedsack, new ID and bed covering, provides luxury upholstery for your old mattresses and box springs and protection for new, furnished by Bedsack. And a Fabergé collection featuring organic shampoo and conditioner, both with pure wheat German honey for fresh-smelling hair with Super Shine and Super Body Organics by Fabergé. And Patton provides powerful cooling comfort to effectively cool an entire home. Patton air circulators, a sensible answer to comfort and energy savings. And a silver tray and delicious pork products, roasts and ribs, steaks and chops, tender, love and fair from the National Pork Producers. And from Zeus, the incredible airless bicycle tire, no tubes, no air, they can't go flat, can't blow out. Zeus, airless tires, they'll never let you down. And Pledge Furniture Polish gives your furniture a clean, clear, more beautiful shine. Pledge for a beautiful difference every time you dust. And a baby mat and changing pad plus Diaperine baby washcloths. Moisture-packed towelettes with lanolin are clean and conditioned. Keep your baby better than clean with Diaperine. This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production. This program has been edited for broadcast.